Welcome to our channel. Today we're diving deep into the world of underground structures. You won't believe what lies beneath our feet. From ancient caves to modern marvels of engineering, humanity has long been fascinated by the hidden depths of our planet. These subterranean spaces, often shrouded in darkness and mystery, serve a myriad of purposes, from providing shelter and protection to housing valuable resources and secrets. Join me as we embark on a journey to uncover the secrets of these underground structures, exploring their history, their significance, and the remarkable ways in which they have shaped our world. Our journey begins in the heart of the Australian outback, a land of scorching sun and unforgiving terrain. This vast expanse of red earth and sparse vegetation stretches as far as the eye can see, embodying both beauty and harshness. Here in this seemingly desolate landscape lies Coober Pedy, a town like no other. Nestled in the middle of nowhere, it stands as a beacon of human resilience and creativity. Coober Pedy is known as the opal capital of the world, its subterranean dwellings a testament to human ingenuity in the face of harsh conditions. The town's opal mines have attracted people from all over the globe, each seeking their fortune beneath the surface. You see, the scorching heat of the outback, often exceeding 120 degrees Fahrenheit, makes living above ground almost unbearable. The relentless sun beats down, creating an environment that is both challenging and awe-inspiring. To escape the relentless sun, the resilient residents of Coober Pedy burrowed underground, creating a network of homes, shops, churches, and even hotels, all carved directly into the cool earth. This underground labyrinth is a marvel of adaptation and survival. These underground dwellings, known as dugouts, provide a welcome respite from the oppressive heat. They offer a sanctuary where the temperature remains constant and comfortable. The constant temperature underground, hovering around a comfortable 70 degrees, makes air conditioning unnecessary. This natural climate control is one of the many ingenious solutions the residents have devised. But Coober Pedy is more than just a curiosity. It's a thriving community where people live, work, and play, all while embracing their unique way of life. It's a testament to the human spirit, a demonstration of our ability to adapt and thrive in even the most challenging environments. The people of Coober Pedy have turned adversity into opportunity. The town's unique lifestyle, carved out of the earth itself, is a testament to the enduring bond between humanity and our planet. This bond is evident in every aspect of life here. It's a reminder that even in the harshest of landscapes, life and indeed community find a way. The spirit of togetherness and mutual support is palpable in Coober Pedy. The ingenuity on display in Coober Pedy serves as an introduction to the world of underground structures. These structures are not just functional, but also a reflection of the community's resilience and creativity. It highlights the practical reasons why humans throughout history have sought refuge and purpose beneath the surface. From ancient times to modern days, the underground has always been a place of mystery and survival. Let us now journey to a place where the underground is not just a refuge, but a canvas for artistry and faith. Here, the subterranean world transforms into a realm of beauty and spirituality. Our next destination takes us to Poland, to the historic town of Wielicka, home to a subterranean wonder that has captivated visitors for centuries, the Wielicka salt mine, a marvel of human ingenuity and perseverance. This UNESCO World Heritage Site is a testament to human artistry and faith, a place where history and craftsmanship converge, a labyrinth of tunnels and chambers carved from the very bones of the earth, salt stretching for miles beneath the surface. For over 700 years, miners have toiled in the depths of Wielicka, extracting salt that was once more precious than gold, a vital resource for survival and trade. But the miners of Wielicka didn't just extract salt, they shaped it, molded it, breathed life into it, creating a unique underground world. Over generations, they carved magnificent chapels, altars, and statues, transforming the mine into an underground cathedral of awe-inspiring beauty, a sanctuary of stone and salt. The most breathtaking of these subterranean sanctuaries is the Chapel of St. Kinga, a masterpiece of devotion and craftsmanship. A colossal chamber adorned with chandeliers made of salt crystals that shimmer like diamonds in the dim light, casting a magical glow. The walls of the chapel are adorned with intricate carvings depicting scenes from the Bible, each a labor of love and faith. Each carving is a testament to the miner's faith and artistry, a blend of devotion and skill. It's a symphony in salt, a testament to human devotion carved from the earth itself, a place where the spirit of the miners lives on. The Velitska salt mine is a testament to the power of human creativity, a monument to what can be achieved with vision and determination, a reminder that even in the darkest depths beauty can be found, and that human spirit can illuminate the darkest corners. It's a place where faith and artistry intertwine, where the sacred and the artistic merge seamlessly, where the earth itself becomes a canvas for human expression, a testament to the enduring spirit of creativity. From the practical ingenuity of Kuberpedi to the artistic splendor of Velitska, we see the diverse ways humans adapt and create. We've seen how underground structures can reflect the diverse facets of human endeavor, each unique and remarkable in its own right. But our journey into the hidden depths of our planet is far from over. There are still many wonders to uncover and stories to tell. Our exploration now takes us to the bustling metropolis of Beijing, China, a city teeming with life both above and below ground. The streets are filled with the hustle and bustle of daily life, a stark contrast to the hidden world that lies beneath. Beneath the modern skyscrapers and ancient temples lies a hidden world, a relic of the Cold War era known as the Beijing Underground City. This subterranean labyrinth is a fascinating blend of history and engineering. Constructed in the 1960s and 70s at the height of tensions between China and the Soviet Union, this vast network of tunnels and bunkers was designed to shelter Beijing's population in the event of a nuclear attack. The fear of nuclear warfare was a driving force behind its creation. This subterranean city, stretching for miles beneath the city streets, was a marvel of engineering and a testament to the anxieties of a turbulent era. The sheer scale and complexity of the project are awe-inspiring. It was equipped with everything needed to sustain life air filtration systems, water reservoirs, and even power generation facilities to ensure a self-sufficient environment. Even schools and hospitals, all designed to function independently from the world above. These facilities were meticulously planned to provide a semblance of normalcy in an otherwise dire situation. Though never used for its intended purpose, the Beijing Underground City stands as a stark reminder of the geopolitical tensions that gripped the world for much of the 20th century. It is a silent witness to a time when the threat of nuclear war loomed large. Today, parts of this subterranean labyrinth have been opened to the public, offering a glimpse into a bygone era. Visitors can explore these tunnels and imagine the lives that might have been lived here. Visitors can wander through the dimly lit tunnels, marveling at the ingenuity and scale of the project. The experience is both eerie and enlightening, providing a tangible connection to the past. It's a sobering reminder of the destructive power of nuclear weapons and the lengths to which nations went to protect their citizens. The underground city is a testament to human resilience and ingenuity in the face of potential catastrophe. The Beijing Underground City stands in stark contrast to the natural wonders of Kuberpedi, where people live underground to escape the harsh desert climate, and the artistic achievements of Velitska, a salt mine turned into a subterranean art gallery. It reminds us that not all underground structures are born from necessity or artistic inspiration. Some are born from fear and the need for security. The Beijing Underground City is a poignant reminder of a world that once was, shaped by the ever-present threat of nuclear conflict. Our journey now takes us across the globe to Montreal, Canada, a city renowned for its vibrant culture and European charm. But beneath the bustling streets of Montreal lies a hidden world, a subterranean network that connects the city in a way few others can match, the RISO. Short for Réseau Piétonnier, French for pedestrian network, the RISO is a sprawling underground city, a labyrinth of tunnels and corridors spanning over 20 miles beneath the heart of Montreal. This subterranean world is far more than just a series of tunnels. It's an integral part of Montreal life, a climate-controlled haven from the harsh Canadian winters and scorching summer heat. Millions of people traverse the RISO every day, accessing a vast array of shops, restaurants, hotels, cinemas, and even universities, all connected by a network of pedestrian walkways and public transportation. But the RISO is more than just a convenient way to navigate the city. It's a symbol of Montreal's ingenuity and its commitment to creating a livable and vibrant urban environment. It's a testament to the power of urban planning and the potential of underground spaces to enhance our cities. The RISO challenges our perceptions of what an underground structure can be. It's not a refuge from danger, nor a canvas for art, but a thriving extension of the city itself, seamlessly integrated into the fabric of daily life. Our final destination takes us to the remote Norwegian archipelago of Svalbard, deep within the Arctic Circle. Here, nestled within a frozen mountain on the island of Spitsbergen, lies a structure of immense importance, a beacon of hope for the future of humanity, the Svalbard Global Seed Vault. Often referred to as the Doomsday Vault, this secure seed bank serves as the ultimate safety net for our planet's biodiversity, a safeguard against the loss of vital food crops due to natural disasters, climate change, or even global conflict. Deep within the permafrost at a constant temperature of minus 18 degrees Celsius, the vault houses over a million seed samples from around the world, representing a vast array of plant genetic diversity. These seeds are carefully packaged and stored in sealed envelopes, ensuring their preservation for generations to come. The Svalbard Global Seed Vault is a testament to our collective responsibility to protect our planet's biodiversity, a symbol of hope for a sustainable future. It's a reminder that even in the face of uncertainty and potential catastrophe, humanity is capable of coming together to safeguard the future of life on Earth. The vault stands as a symbol of our interconnectedness, a testament to the importance of international cooperation in addressing global challenges. From the sun-baked outback of Australia to the frozen Arctic, our journey has taken us to the far reaches of our planet, exploring the diverse and remarkable world of underground structures. We've seen how these hidden spaces reflect our ingenuity, our creativity, our fears, and our hopes for the future. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more amazing content. See you next time. From the practical necessities of shelter, to the artistic expressions of faith, and the grand visions of a sustainable future, underground structures offer a unique window into the human experience. As we've seen, the world beneath our feet is far from hidden. It's an integral part of who we are, a testament to our past, present, and future. So keep exploring, keep questioning, and never stop marveling at the wonders that lie hidden.